My name is Dan Spevack, and I am director of the Montefiore Echo Lab, and I am highly involved in the Montefiore Einstein Cardiology Fellowship Program. The fellows all rotate a substantial amount of time through non-invasive imaging, and we do a lot of education about echocardiography, transesophageal echocardiography, and stress testing, and fellows learn a lot about cardiac hemodynamics while they're in our lab, and you know, this is mainly what we do. Early on in the fellowship, the focus of the training of the fellows is on how to obtain good echo images, how to become a good sonographer, because it's important to start from there. They should know how to obtain images yourself. And then as the fellowship goes on, we concentrate more on interpretation of the echo images. And then the more senior fellows get more heavily involved with the more advanced imaging techniques, transesophageal echo and stress echo interpretation. And those who are, you know, really interested in echo learn about some of the more advanced techniques, such as 3D echo and strain rate imaging and speckle tracking and things like that. But like all, you know, cardiology fellowships at major academic medical centers, we have all the pieces that that we have the solid foundation. So you know, we have a strong department of cardiology, but also I think it's important to have a strong overall medical center. And you know, you could pick any major organ system, and you know, Montefiore does transplants in those areas. We have a really well-developed basic science laboratories at the medical school, and there's lots of opportunities for collaborations between departments, between the basic science and clinical medicine. So I think that the foundation is very strong. That, you know, and probably you find some similar setups at all the top-tier programs around the country. So some of the things that set us apart from those places, though, is I think that our collaborative efforts are very easy. There's a nice collaboration between a lot of the departments, that a lot of sort of turf battles that you hear about at other centers. There's a kind of a culture at Montefiore of cooperation and collaboration. And to me, that's made working here a very pleasant place to work, and it certainly trickles down to the fellow level. So, you know, I think that within cardiology, some of the things that have made us famous here is our arrhythmia department. The first pacemaker was put in at Montefiore, and our arrhythmia group is sort of a world-renowned group that the head of the department, John Fisher, is chair of the major arrhythmia organization, the Heart Rhythm Society, and he's editor-in-chief of PACE, which is the premier journal in arrhythmia. That's sort of, you know, I guess what Montefiore Cardiology is most famous for, but I think the cath lab is very strong, and the non-invasive imaging has always been very strong, and now with our new chief of cardiology, Dr. Garcia, it's become non-invasive imaging has become a major focus in our division, and I think we'll continue to grow. I went to New York University for my fellowship experience, and I thought it was wonderful there. I certainly felt like I was equipped with many of the tools that were necessary to succeed, and I was able to come out and, you know, get a job working here in academia, and working with cardiology fellows and publishing research and seeing cardiology patients. And So I feel like that from background of coming from a good program, that put me in a position to do what I wanted to do. I feel like I see our fellows graduating, and I think that we also provide a lot of that our fellows, you know, when they graduate, are all, actually can't say all, but I would say the vast majority are extremely pleased with where they ended up. And that we're able to provide our fellows with the experience to do what they want to do when they graduate is I think fantastic. You know, NYU, for being a great program, did miss some certain things. When I came here, I had to virtually train myself in heart failure and transplant and left ventricular assist devices, because that was something that just was simply not done at NYU at the time when I was a fellow there. So I think the diversity of experience that we have here may be a little bit greater because of programs like that. So I think that's also one of our strengths. We try to keep a very warm, like sort of safe environment for our fellows. We try to make it so that, you know, that this is the time where you really, in your training, where you really get to work one-on-one with an attending much more often than you have in the past. And you can get all those, you know, feel very comfortable with your basics of knowledge, because you asked all the questions that you had floating around that you were kind of afraid to get out earlier in your training. You know, we work really hard in all of our departments here to sort of create this environment of learning and collaboration. And I think that's one of the things that makes this a fun place to work.